एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज एपी और अर्थमैटिक प्रोग्रेशन. सो एज वी हैव ऑब्जर्व्ड सो मेनी थिंग्स इन नेचर विच फॉलोज अ सर्टेन पैटर्न, फॉर एग्जांपल पाइनएप्पल, डेडर. सिमिलरली इन एपी और अर्थमैटिक प्रोग्रेशन वी आर हैविंग सीक्वेंस ऑफ नंबर्स दैट फॉलो अ फिक्स्ड पैटर्न. लेट्स टेक एन एग्जांपल, 8, 10, 12, 40. Okay, here you can see that when we add 2 to 8, what we get? 10. Similarly, when we add 2 to 10, we get 12. After that, 14. So, we are having a sequence of numbers that follow a certain pattern. As we can see that the successive term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term. If we add 2 to 8, we get 10. Similarly, 10, 12, 14. After that, 16. So we are having a fixed pattern with a common difference 2. So this is what? This is a sequence of numbers that form an AP or arithmetic progression. So AP is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term. Here in this case, we are adding 2 to every preceding number and we get the successive numbers. But here we are in a condition that we need not to add that fixed number to the first term. So AP is what? AP is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to the preceding term except the first number. Okay, now we will study what is common difference of an AP. First of all, common difference of an AP is denoted by D, small d. Now we are taking an example, 3, 6, 9, 12. This is an AP. Now we have to find its common difference. Okay, 3, 6. So common difference is 6 minus 3 equals to 3. Simply, when we subtract second term, okay, when we subtract first term of an AP from the second term, we get common difference. Or with the help of these two terms, we can also find common difference. So D equals to A, 3 minus A, 2. So 9 minus 6 gives 3. Similarly, with the help of these two terms, A4 minus A3, so 12 minus 9 gives 3. So this is common difference. Let's take another example, 1 minus 1 minus 3 minus 5. Now we have to find the common difference of this given AP. Now, common difference is A2 minus A1, so minus 1, minus 1, which is equal to minus 2. Again, A3 minus A2, so A3 minus A2. Again, what we get? Minus 2. So in this case, common difference is minus 2. That is a negative number. And in this case, common difference is a positive number. Another example is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is also an AP, but what about its common difference? Yes, 2 minus 1, 1, 3 minus 2, 1. Another example here, also positive. So 1, 1, 1, 1. Is this an AP or not? Yes, this is an AP. Here, common difference is A2 minus A1, 0. Again, A3 minus A2, 0. So here in this case, common difference is 0. So we can say that common difference of an AP is a positive, negative or 0. Positive number bhi ho sakta hai, negative bhi ho sakta hai. So AP, so common difference of an AP is either a positive number, negative number or 0. As we are having so many sequence of numbers that follow a certain pattern, so we have to define the general form of an AP. So let's define it. We are taking the same example, 8, 10, 12 and 14. And we have observed that this pattern is having a common difference of 2. So here in AP, we will define this common difference by D. And in this case, D is 2. Now, we will denote the first term of an AP by a. The first term is denoted by a, or you can say a1. Similarly, second term a2. After that a3, a4, and the last term, that is an, because we don't know how many terms are there, so we will define the last term by an. Now a1 is what? A1 is 8. We need not to add any common difference to it. So a1 equals to 8. Similarly a2, when we add 2 to 8 we get 10, and here a2 is 10. So when we add 8, sorry, when we add 2 to 8, or we can say that when we add d2 first term, when we add d2 first term, here this is d and this is a. So when we add this common difference to first term, we get second term a2 equals to a plus d. Similarly a3 equals to a plus, okay, here a plus d. Now a3 equals to a plus twice of d. You can check, when we add twice of common difference to a, we get a3. Let's take it, a equals to 8, and common difference in this case equals to 2, so twice of common difference is this. So what we get, a3 equals to 12 and a3 equals to 12. Done. So we can say that a3 equals to a plus, okay, a3, so a plus 3 minus 1 into d, because we are having twice, so we can write 3 minus 1. Similarly a2 equals to a plus d, or we can write a plus 2 minus 1 into d. Now a4, that is a plus again 4 minus 1 into d. Here we are having 4, so we have to write this 4 minus 1, a3 that is 3 minus 1, a2 that is 2 minus 1. Similarly a5, that is a plus 5 minus 1 into d. We have to check this value. Here n equals to 4, so we have to write n minus 1 into d, that is 4 minus 1 into d. Here we are having n equals to 5, so we have to write 5 minus 1 into d. So directly a plus 3d. Similarly a5, we can write a plus 4d. Now we have to define this also, that is last term, an is last term. You can write an or l. This is last term of an AP, which is denoted by an or l. Now we have to define last term. So here an equals to a plus, if we are having 5, then what we have to write, 5 minus 1. If we are having 4, so we have to write 4 minus 1. And in an we are having n, so we have to write n minus 1 into d. So this is the general form of an last term of an AP. This is general form of a last term of an AP. An equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. Now we are taking another example. In this example, we have to find the 10th term of an AP, and AP is given to you, 2, 7, 12. Now, you all know how to define nth term of an AP. So an equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. We have to find its 10th term, so we are taking n equals to 10, and according to this AP, first term a equals to 2 and common difference, that is a2 minus a1, so 7 minus 2 gives 5. So in this case common difference is 5, first term is 2 and n is 8. Now put the values, a10, a2, n, that is 10, minus 1 into d, common difference is 5. Simply put the values and get the result. So 2 plus 9 into 5, so a10 equals to 47. So in this way we can find any term of the given AP.